Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mitesh Gala. Welcome to Rough Talk, a learning companion.
Hi, we're getting into a new topic, heights and distances, exercise 22A. Heights and distances is very much related to trigonometrical identities. Basically, the exercise D, if you remember in trigonometry that we had done, where there were some values for sine, cos and tan, and we took the tables and got those values. Exactly those values we are going to use over here. This is basically an extension to trigonometry, or you can say a direct application of trigonometry. Where is trigonometry applied in real life? It is applied to find heights and distances. Exactly, that's what the topic is all about. For example, you will be given that this is a building, let's say building, and you are standing at this point A. And when you look at the top of the building, you can find the angle at which you are looking up. How will you find the height of the building? So instead of actually going and measuring the height of the building, what you're going to do is you'll find this angle over here. Let's say the angle is 45 degrees and you will find this distance, that is the distance of yourself from the building, let's say 40 meters. And then we use all the trigonometric ratios. For example, if I say tan 45, that is opposite BL upon adjacent AL. Tan 45, we know the value of the table is 1. Remember the values which you use in standard 9. BL upon AL, which is 40, and therefore the height of the building also becomes 40 meters. So this angle can vary anything from 0 to 90. You can take that value from the table, substitute that here, multiply it with 40, and you will get the height of the building straight away. So before we get straight to the topic, three things you need to understand. Number one, there is something called as angle of elevation. Number two, there is something called as angle of depression. So first, let's understand these two things, okay? So let's say if the person is standing here at this point and he is looking up to a particular thing. So the person is standing on the ground. So this angle which he makes, this angle is called as the angle of elevation because he is looking on top. And let's say this is the building and someone is on the top of the building, and when that person looks down, then this angle that he creates with the horizon over here is called as angle of depression. This is not the angle of depression. Don't get confused. Angle of depression is with the horizon. Horizon is this line which we create, the imaginary line. That is called the angle of depression. Angle of depression, very, very important. Many a times people don't understand this and they mess up the angle of depression. So I want you to pay attention to that carefully. We have one question on depression in this exercise. That time we will talk about depression in length. The next thing you need to know is the ratios. Sine opposite upon hypotenuse, cos adjacent upon hypotenuse, and tan opposite upon adjacent. You don't need to find the other three, only these three are more than enough for you to get the entire topic. So to get the entire topic, you should know this. Why? Just in case you know this angle and you want to find any of these sides, so you have to select which ratio. If I want to find BL, I will use tan opposite upon adjacent. If I want to find AB, then I will use sine, hypotenuse opposite upon hypotenuse, or maybe cos adjacent upon hypotenuse. So depending on what data is given and what you want to find, you're going to use these ratios. The next thing you're expected to know is the standard value for 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90, at least for sine, cos and tan. These three we need to know. So sine 0 is 0, sine 30 is half, 45 1 by root 2, sine 60 root 3 by 2, and sine 90 is 1. This was done in standard 9. If you remember how to do it, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, divide by 4 each term and take the square root of each term. Whatever answer you get automatically will match. See, 0 by 0 is 0, 0 ka root 0, 1 ka root 1, 4 root 2, cancel, so I'll get 1 upon root 2, root 3, and 4 is root will give you 2, cancel, so 1 ka root is 1. Cos is exactly ulta of all this. So 1 comes here, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, half, and finally 0. And tan is division of these two, that is 0. Here you will get 1 by root 3 when you divide these two 1, root 3 and infinite. Out of that, these three are very important. Most of the times we use tan 30, 45 and 60. So I expect you to know this table by heart. Okay. You are going to use two tables. One is this, which we don't call it as table. These are just values. And second is the table behind the textbook, which you have like this. Tan, cos and sin. So we are going to use these values if the numbers are not these numbers. That means if they are not standard angles, in that case we will go behind and use the table. So this much elevation, depression, sine, cos, tan, opposite, hypotenuse, whatever, and these values. If you know this, you are through with this chapter. If you don't know, take a screenshot, print it, put it on your surfboard. Your life will become easier while we do this topic. So let's begin with sum number 2. The most important thing in the topic is the diagram. If your diagram goes wrong, you had it. Now here they say, the question reads this way. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from a point on the ground at a distance of 160 meters away is found to be 60 degrees. So angle of elevation is 60 degrees, 160 meters away. Find the height of the tower. How simple. You are just going to use tan, because tan is opposite upon adjacent. So you can directly say in triangle TWG, what will happen? I will say tan 60 is equal to TW upon GW. So tan 60 is root 3, TW I don't know, and GW is 160. So TW is 160 root 3. You should at all times know the value of root 2 and root 3. You can take it from square tables also. So root 3 is 1.732. You can't leave the answer here. You are expected to give the answer in decimals, at least two decimal places. Not at least, give two decimals. So go to 3 and then round it off. So 16 2s are 32, 3. 48 plus 3, 51. 16 7s are 112 plus 5, 117. So 11. 16 plus 11, 27 and the 0. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So my answer should be 277.12 meters. Write the final answer. Therefore, height of the tower is 277.12 meters. You manage it, everybody. Now, was it simple for everyone? Great. Let's go on to the next question. I want everyone to try sum number 4. So fourth one, what does it say? It says, so first draw the diagram, rough diagram, and then come back so you can at least get some hand on it. Okay, the question says two people are standing on the opposite side of the tower. Angle of elevation is 38 and 30. So first one 30, next one 38. Height of the tower is 50. Find the distance between the two people, that is PQ. So your entire question is to find these two. So you will take this triangle, find this. Take this triangle, find WQ, and then you can add them. Most important, whenever you are drawing the diagram, 90 degree is must. If you do not draw 90 degree, board can cut one mark. So don't forget to draw a 90 degree whenever you are drawing a diagram. So first one, let's get into this triangle. In triangle PTPW, we are using tan 30, which is opposite TW upon adjacent PW. So tan 30 is 1 by root 3. You remember the value from that table? Perfect. TW is 50 upon PW. So PW will be 50 into 1.732. So let's multiply and get this sorted. So 10, 5 2s are 10, 15 and 1, 16, 35, 36, 5 plus 3, 8. 3 decimals, so 86.16 meters is this distance, PW. Now for WQ. Now there is a catch over here which you need to understand very well. If I use tan 38, I'll have to take the value from behind, so my value will be here, equals to 50 upon WQ. So WQ will go up, 50 will stay here, and this 38 ka value will come down. So in short, you'll have 50 divided by 0 point something, and dividing that is very difficult. 50 divided by 3 or 4 decimals. So we've got an alternate method. Instead of using this angle, we will use this angle. So our target is what? That whenever you cross this should directly multiply with that decimal. So it becomes easy. So first let's find this angle and then I'll tell you what I'm trying to say. So angle WTQ is going to be 180 minus 90 minus 38. Angle sum property. So 52, that should be 80 and 90, correct. So therefore tan 52, that is this angle, tan 52 of this opposite WQ and adjacent TW. Why did I do this? So now I get WQ, which is unknown, and TW as 50. I'll get this value from the table behind and I can multiply. Multiplying with decimals is easy, but if I had taken 38, it would have been divided. That means 50 divided by that decimal, very difficult. So we are taking this alternate method in order to save our time and to make it possible. So tan 52, so go on to your table behind and look out for the value of 52. So the value for 52 in tan, okay? So 52, 1.2799 is what I can see. So 1.2799 multiply, so I'll get WQ. 5 9s are 45. Again 45 plus 4 49, 35 plus 4 39, 13, 5 and 1 6 and 1 more 0. So 4 decimals. So 63.95. Finally PQ. So therefore PQ is going to be 86.600, 63.995. This 0 I'm not writing. So finally I get 5, 9, 9 plus 6, 15, 9 and 1, 10. Decimal, 14 and 1, 15. So I get 150.59, converting to two decimals. So 150.60 meters is what I am getting the answer. Let me just check so that I don't teach you anything wrong. 150.6, perfect. Accurate answer we've got. So always go for the final decimals and then convert to two decimals in the end so that you are always safe. Are you clear with this sum? Did you understand this technique, why we took 52 and not 38? Otherwise, we would have got confused. Don't forget that, okay? Let's go to the next one, 6th. Now, here they said that a boy is looking at the tower 20 meters away and the angle of elevation is 60 degrees and the height of the boy is 1.6 meters. Find the height of the tower. So this basically over here becomes a rectangle. So if this is 1.6, WR is also 1.6. If this is 20, this also is 20. And then you can take triangle TBW, apply tan and get TW, and then add that with WR to get the height of the tower. So come on, try it on your own without my help completely. First, we'll prove that this is a rectangle. So you say in quadrilateral, BYRW, angle B, sorry, not B, angle Y equals to angle R equals to angle W equals to 90. And therefore quadrilateral BYRW is a rectangle. You don't need to say why you got this 90, just say it's 90, okay? That's all right. So therefore BY is equal to WR equals to 1.6 meters and BW is equal to YR equals to 20 meters. So we got this 20, now apply tan. Come on, pause now at least and go about it on your own. So in triangle TWB, I will say tan 60 is equal to, what will be tan 60? Opposite TW upon adjacent BW. So tan 60, you know the value? Superb, root 3. TW, we don't know, and BW is 20. So multiply, what is root 3? 1.732. So therefore I can say TW, 2 2's are 4, this 0, 3 2's are 6, 14, 2 and 1, 3. 3 decimals, so 34.64 meters. And therefore finally tower, that is TR, 34.64 plus this WR, which you already got as 1.6. So my final answer should be 36.24 meters as the height of the tower. I'm just trying to check so that we don't go wrong. It says 21.6. So we've gone wrong somewhere, it seems. Okay, one minute. Sum number 6. It's correct, 36.24. Now there were two parts here, that's why I got confused. First part they said let the angle be 45. In that case, you will get this 20 because tan 45 is 1. I didn't do that, that's simple. And then you add 1.6 to get 21.6. This is part 2 where the angle of elevation is 60 degrees. So I have picked up the difficult one and the answer is correct for that. How many of you all got the same answer without cheating? Pat yourself, great job. If you are seriously getting it on your own, come on, I am giving you the challenge. Can you get sum number 7? At least get the diagram first. Don't copy from here the diagram. Come on, go away. Draw the diagram on your own and then come back. Pause. Good. Okay. The upper part of the tree broken over by wind makes an angle of 45 degrees with the ground. So this is the whole tree from TE. It's broken at point R and this part has come down to the ground making an angle of 45 degrees. This distance they said is 15 meters. Can you find the height of the tree? So your target is to find TE. First find RE, then find RG. Say RG equals to TR because it is the same part which is broken. And when you add these two, TE plus RG, you will get TE straight away. That is the height of the tree. So now the question is, how will you get RE first? So you can say tan 45, opposite adjacent, get RE. How will you get RG? Sin 45. Once you get this, then say sin 45 opposite upon hypotenuse and get RG. And then add the two to get the tree. It's very simple, isn't it? Very good question from exam point of view. Come on, hit it. So you start by saying in triangle REG, okay, this triangle, I will say tan 45 opposite RE adjacent EG. So tan 45 is 1, RE is unknown and EG is 15. So therefore RE shall become 15 meters. So we got this one part. Now trying to get the second part, this time I will say sin 45. So sin 45 is opposite RE upon hypotenuse RG. Yeah, sin 45, what are the value you remember? Superb, 1 by root 2, I'm impressed. RE, you already got 15 upon RG. So RG will be 15 into root 2. You should know the value of root 2, otherwise you can take it from square table, 1.414. Try and learn this root 3 and root 2 at least, okay? So RG, 15 fours are 60, 21, 62, 15 plus 6, 21. So it's going to be 21.21 meters as RG. Finally say RG equals to TR equals to 21.21. And therefore the height of the tree TE is going to be 15 plus 21.21, 36.21 meters. In the end, right, therefore the height of the tree is 36.21 meters. So therefore the height of the tree is 36.21 meters. Got everyone? Was this interesting question? Yeah, the main trick was that this is equal to this. People fail to understand. They draw this and then they work out. They don't know this angle and then they mess up the entire sum. Yeah. Ninth, they say, it's a good question, not very difficult. The angle of elevation, at a particular time when the sun's altitude, so sun altitude means when you look at the sun, is 30 degrees. The length of the shadow, this is your shadow and this is the tower. So when the tower, the sun sign falls on the tower, the shadow falls here and this is the length of the shadow as 45 meters. Calculate the height of the tower is your question. So they have given you two options here. First find the height of the tower and then length of the shadow when this is 45 or 60. So I'm not doing all that, you can manage it. But first get this one first, height of the tower. So obviously you're going to use tan. So in triangle TWS, I will say tan 30, opposite is TW, adjacent is WS. So tan 30, 1 by root 3, opposite we don't know and WS is 45. Cross multiply, so TW 45 upon root 3, rationalize the denominator, so this will become 45 root 3 upon 3, cancel, so I'll get 15 root 3, that is 15 into 1.732, 15 twos are 30, 45, 48, 109, 10, 25 and 3 decimals, so 25.98, so you can say therefore height of the tower is 25.98 meters. Let me just check, this is sum number 9 and the answer is correct. You can try this with 45, 60, get these values different and then try the same logic. Come on, try the rest of the two parts on your own. I am not doing it for you. You want everything ready, mate? Sorry. Chalo, next one. Sum number 11. Draw the diagram on your own. You want everything free of cost, huh? Come on, try it, 11th, and then come back. Very good question. Okay. Pause. Okay, now that you're back, how many did A here and B here? Perfect. How many did B over here and A over here? Exchange these positions. Honestly, tell me, huh? You messed up. Because they said B is 57 degrees and A is 48 degrees. So automatically A is below B. These are two climbers climbing the cliff. And for a person 40 meters away from the cliff, he sees, when he sees up, the angle of elevation as 48 to A and 57 to B. Question is, what is the distance between these two climbers? That is distance between AB. So very simple. I am losing one mark here. Can you tell me why? 90 degree mark. Very important. You need to mark this 90. So I'll take this triangle first. Apply tan 48 and get AD. Then take the bigger triangle. Apply tan 57 and get BD. From BD subtract AD. What I will get is the distance between the two climbers. Easy? Try it. Come on. Multiplication is slightly lengthy here, but try it. You should, huh? Don't copy from your cheaters. Please go away. Try on your own. So number one, in triangle, I'm taking the bigger one first, BCD. Tan 57 is equal to BD upon 40. So tan 57, you'll have to go to the table and get the answer for tan 57. So here you go, tan 57 is right over here. And what's the value? So tan 57, 1.5399. So 1.5399 multiplied by 40 is BD. So therefore BD will become 10, 9 4s are 36, 36 plus 3 39, 12 plus 3 12 plus 3 15, 21 2 4 5 6 and 4 decimals. So 61.596. I am not very confident. Should I just calculate it once again, please? 36, 39, 12, 15, 21. Yeah, mostly yes. Now let's take the second triangle, that is ADC. This time tan 48. So what will be tan 48? AD upon 40 again. So let's calculate, look at the value of tan 48. So tan 48 is given to you as 1.1106 into 40 will be AD. So therefore AD becomes 10, 6 4s are 24, 4, 4 and 1 more 4. Decimals will be 4, so 444.424 meters, and therefore AB, that will be 61.596 minus 44.424. Please pray, I don't want to go wrong. So 2, 7, 1, 6 and 1, 7, 2 and 1, 7. So you can say 17.17 meters. Write the final answer in two decimals. Before that, don't convert into two decimals. Stay as it is till the end. Only in the end convert. In the boards, many a times when I have corrected, I have cancelled lot of marks here. So please see to it. They directly here only they convert into two decimals. That's wrong. You should convert only in the end. Okay. So your answer should be 17.17. And finally, you can say, therefore, the distance between A and B is 17.17 meters. Got it? Great. Let's go to the next one. Sum number 12. On your own, come on, try on your own, don't cheat. Get the diagram, then come back, stop laughing, pause. Okay, they say a man is standing 9 meters away from a flagpole. So man's height is there, some height must be there. So MN for me is the man. When he looks up, that is angle of elevation 28, angle of depression. So depression means this is the eye of the man and he's looking at the bottom of the pole. Angle is with the horizon, not this angle, this angle is 13 degrees. Your question is find the height of the pole, that is FP. So you will say that this is a rectangle because 90, 90, 90. So this 9 ml also 9. Then take this triangle, apply tan and get LP. Take this triangle, apply tan 28, get FL. And then add the two to get FP. Come on your own. Pause the video. Try it. On your own. I don't want anyone to copy from here. Go away. Try on your own. Okay. So first, proving it is a rectangle. So in quadrilateral, M, N, P, L. Angle N equals to P equals to L equals to 90. Why is it 90? You don't need to say. Therefore, quadrilateral M, N, P, L is a rectangle. Once you got this as a rectangle, therefore, ML equals to LP, sorry, NP equals to 9 meters. So we managed to get this as 9. Now jump into one of the triangles. So I am taking MLP, this bottom triangle, and tan 13 LP, we don't know, and ML, which is 9. So tan 13, we'll have to take the values from the tan table. So let's look at it. Tan 13 2309 into 9 is LP. So finally I can say LP, 9 9s are 81, 27, 18 plus 2, 20, and 4 decimals. So 2.0781. Getting into the next triangle, that is MFL. This time tan 28, FL upon 9. So tan 28, let's look at the value. Tan 28, 5317. 0.5317 into 9 FL. So my FL becomes 963. 9 ones are 9 plus 6. 9 ones are 9 plus 6, I forgot. 9 plus 6, come on, tell me somebody. 15. 27 and 1, 28. 47, 4. 4 decimals. Meters. I hope I have done this correct. I am not very sure because I suddenly got stuck. Let me check. 63, 6. 9 plus 6, 15. 27, 28. 45, 47. Hopefully. So therefore, FP, the full thing, is this plus this. So 2.0781 and 4.7853. So let's add it. 4, 13, 15, 16, 8.6. So you can say therefore FP 6.86 meters. They've not asked you to round off or anything. So you can write it in two decimals as 6.83. I hope I am correct. 6.86, and that's correct. Good job. You are really doing a very good job. Let's go further. I want you to try one more sum, 13th. The last question. Again, one mark lost. Can you tell me why? Oh, you saw the diagram. First draw and then come back, cheaters. Okay, it says, from the top of a cliff 92 meters high, the angle of depression of the buoy. Buoy means what? Buoy is basically something like this in shape. Cone with a hemisphere made of some material which floats on water. So this is used in most of the ships. In case if you are sinking in water, they throw this so that you can hold it and you can float. So it's a floating material called as buoy. Okay, so from the top of the cliff 92 meters high, the angle of the depression of the buoy is 20 degrees. This is not 20, don't mess up. Angle of depression is with the horizon. This is your horizon. So with this, the angle is 20 degrees. I call this as H only. Okay, calculate to the nearest meter the distance of the buoy from the cliff, that is BL. One mark lost. Can you tell me why? 90 degree mark not there. Yeah, this distance you need to find. So first thing you're going to say is angle HCB is equal to CBL. Reason, alternate angles, and therefore angle CBL becomes 20 degrees. So this is 20 now. So now I can say tan this upon this and get the value of this straight away. So I will say tan 20 is equal to CL upon BL. So tan 20, we'll have to look at the value for tan. So let's look at it for 20. 0.3640. So 0.3640. CL is 92. I messed this up. Can you tell me why did I mess up? Yeah, because now this is going to come down. And in that case, I'll have to divide. So what we'll have to do is we have to take this angle instead of this. See, this is the problem I was talking about. Let me do this so that you come to know the problem. 92 by 0.3640. Now dividing 92 by this is going to be madness. So you should never do this. So cancel this and get this third angle. So that will be angle BCL. Yeah, 180 minus 90 minus 20, which will be 70. Good, I made this mistake, I believe. Yeah, so therefore tan 70 now, this one is equal to BL upon CL. So tan 70 ka value, let's pick up from behind. Tan 70, 2.7475. So 2.7475, BL is unknown and CL is 92. So therefore BL 2.7475 into 92. Multiplying possible, division not possible. So you should not use this technique, use this technique. Whatever you multiply, then you get your final answer. So let's multiply. 27475 multiplied by 92. 5 2s are 10, 36, 37, 12, 13, 14, 15, 14 and 1, 15, 4 and 1, 5. 9 4 5s are 45, 4. 67, 6, 36 plus 6, 43, 36 plus 6, 42, 4, 63, 67, 6, 18 plus 6, 24, I don't know whether I'm multiplying it correct or no, just pray please, 8, 12, 5 and 2, so I get 252.83, 4 decimals, so 1, 2, 3, 4, so 252.832. They said to the nearest meter. So convert this. 2 goes away, 3 goes away. How do you convert nearest? So if this is 5 or greater than 5, you add. Less than 5, you cancel. Less than 5, cancel. Greater than 5, add. So my final answer should be 253 meters. So good, I made this mistake. Now you know what is the problem when you do this. And if there is a problem, what is the solution to it? Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got a good hand on heights and distance. The next time we meet, we go ahead with the next exercise of heights and distance, exercise B, which is slightly more interesting. Until the next video, your homework, sum number 3, 5, 8 and 10. Please see to it you do your homework honestly. Don't expect me to do these sums. You should try so that you get some self-study on your own.
Hope you had a lovely mathematics experience with a rough book. Our learning companion.